What's up, Brand Builder? My name is Mash Bonigala, and welcome to another episode of the Brand Builder Show, where I post daily videos on creating, building, launching, and marketing your brand. In this episode, we talk about how to improve your brand visual imagery. When business owners look at their brand visual imagery, they usually see the obvious elements such as their logo design, stationery design, and perhaps a few other elements such as their social media channels and their websites, all of which simply have their logo maybe slapped onto them. But a brand's visual imagery goes much deeper than that. Successful brands create and use visual imagery that ties into human emotions and seeps deep into the various touch points that their target audience, including packaging and campaign imagery. The way a brand's visual imagery is created and utilized can either infuriate a customer base or dramatically increase sales. Evaluate brand visual requirements. A carefully crafted visual identity can unify a brand and communicate the right kind of message to the target audience. By evaluating and defining the key elements of your visual branding, you can ensure that your brand visual imagery is working for your brand and not against it. The key elements of your visual imagery are relevance, quality, and consistency. Now let's look at each of these and discuss what they are. Relevance. Do the visuals align with and support your brand strategy and brand promise? Are they relevant to your brand message? Are they relevant to your target audience? These are the questions that need to be asked when evaluating your brand visual imagery. Next, quality. Do not skimp on your brand's visual imagery. If required, reduce the company beer budget and invest in getting high quality visual elements. I'm kidding, but you know what I mean. Spend money on a professional logo design and brand identity. These are fundamental to your brand visual language. Invest in getting a professional website design. Businesses that skimp on their website always end up paying 100 times more in terms of the lost opportunity cost. Now, set aside budget for custom channel branding of your social media channels. Do not give in to the temptation of using the same visuals for all your social media channels. That's what most people do. Avoid using images from Google search. Instead, invest in a decent stock photo subscription or use high-quality photos by royalty-free websites. Last, consistency. The biggest issue with most businesses is the lack of consistency when it comes to their brand's visual imagery. Inconsistency can come in the form of their logo usage, fonts, colors, typography, and style of photos, tone and voice of messaging. There are many more elements to it. Being consistent in your use of visual language is very difficult without an editorial overview of your content. As a minimum, identify one individual in your company who is responsible for reviewing all your brand visual content. Create solid brand identity guidelines and adhere to them strictly. Create brand visuals. Creation of your brand visuals must be assigned to a professional who has experience and understands your brand message. Now, I'm going to talk about a few items which are the minimum brand visual assets that you would need to build a successful brand. The first is the primary brand mark. This is your primary logo design, which acts as the official symbol of the brand. It should follow the following principles, design guidelines, so to speak. Your logo should be original and unique. An original logo is worth its weight in gold. The world is full of brands with cheap and uninspiring logos. It should be distinct. Your logo should be distinct, not just visually, but in terms of the feelings it creates and the emotions it stirs. It should be versatile. Your logo should be flexible and should work well at all sizes and in all media. It should be targeted. Your logo should be created for your target audience, and not just for the stakeholders or the owners or just for yourself. It is not enough that you like your logo. Your logo should connect with your customers and potential customers. It should be memorable. Your logo should create brand recall, and your target audience should be able to recognize it easily. It should be timeless. Your logo should not be blindly following the latest design trends just because they're cool. It should be timeless and work for your brand for years to come without having the need to constantly rebrand your company, which is expensive. Next comes the secondary brand mark. It is always advisable to have a secondary brand mark that would support your primary logo and enhance the overall brand message. The secondary brand mark can be utilized, create variety by using it on social media channels, packaging, menus, and more. A secondary brand mark can also be used as a watermark or a stamp or a seal. The possibilities are endless. Next comes the official brand pattern. Every brand requires an official brand pattern that can be made up of elements from the primary logo or the secondary logo, secondary brand mark, or with design elements that are consistent with the overall brand language. An official brand pattern can be used effectively on the website, package design, printed sales materials such as brochures, and in the office decoration. An official brand pattern creates a larger than life effect on the audience. When they encounter a subtle pattern that is strategically placed and repeated at various touch points, your audience will perceive the brand to be a sophisticated and a solid one. Create a distinct photo template. Before you do anything else, it is crucial to identify and nail down a distinct look and feel for the photos you would use in your content marketing. Now, of course, this includes photos you use on your website, the blog, your social media channels, and of course, the brand print materials. As I said before, once you have signed up for a subscription with one of the popular stock photo websites, brainstorm and come up with ideas for design elements that can be added to the photos before publishing them. So these design elements should make the photos distinct, and one should be able to recognize a photo as belonging to your brand. You could also apply filters or maybe have a kind of a color tone to them. Now, I understand that this is easier said than done, but with a little planning and effort, it can be done. Now, here are a few ideas that can make your photos distinct. When posting content on your blog, for instance, pick photos that are not too literal representations of the topic. Instead, try to find photos that abstractly hint at the topic. If, for example, your topic is about competition, instead of a stock photo of business people in suits, at the start line of a race, ready to run a race, post a photo of children competing for something, or maybe even animals. If you're posting a photo on your social media channels for, let's say, Thanksgiving Day, rather than the usual stock photo of food and, you know, pumpkins and Thanksgiving-related items, post a personal photo of your team sharing a pizza. It is to get the personality of the brand across. If at all possible, take photos of your product in contexts that are related to the topic you're writing about. That way, you can post photos that contain your product, but only in the background or on the periphery, and not salesy in nature. Now, this can create a great connection with your audience. Create and use distinct photo filters that would identify photos that you post. Now, this topic is quite large, and this video may not do justice to it. However, there are other videos that I have done that cover other areas of improving your brand's visual language, including making your package design stand out, making your dull product interesting, or creating powerful sales materials, creating a powerful publicity strategy, improving your brand message, and many more. So keep tuned, subscribe to this channel, and go and dig deep to find related videos. I hope you found this episode useful. If you have any questions about this episode, please hit me up on Twitter. My handle is @Bonigala. Or leave comments below this video and I will surely respond. And as always, don't forget to subscribe to the Brand Builder Show channel so that you get alerted when my next video comes out. Till my next video, take care.